Namaste. This is Mekla here from poojas.in. Today I am shooting this video from this holy place called Tirchandur. You may be observing that there is a gopuram there. That is the temple, the Tirchandur Subramanya Swami temple. This is where he vanquished the demon Tarakasur, and in Tamil Nadu they call Tarakasur as Surapadman. So this is a very powerful kshetra which was never affected by tsunami. And in today's video I'd like to tell you why I'm here. So we are here basically to get a puja done for one of our clients who is going through Shatrubada. So the dasha was such that the Shashtadipati dasha is going on, and a lot of problems at work, lot of insecurities in the job front, lot of challenges posed by colleagues and you know, senior officers, and basically animosity and Shatrubada is what we say. And since Karthikeya Subramanya is a Senadipati, and he is the one who is a warrior, like he is capable of handling the army of Ishwara, and also he also is in the forefront of always killing the asuras or the demons or vanquishing them. This place is a very sacred place for anybody who would want to do Shatru Samhara Puja. We get it done. It's a Homa actually which we do, wherein Subramanya is propitiated through the six faces that he has. The Armugam is what he is known as here. And because he has six faces, each of the face has actually invoked with blessings through the Subramanya Swami Trishati. So when we chant the Trishati, the priests will do it very well. Six priests sit together and then they chant the Trishati. First the Avahna happens, and then Varuna Puja is there, and we do the Pradakshina Namaskara, or three Namaskaras. We do 11 Namaskaras, with three Pradakshina Namaskaras and 11 Namaskaras, prostrations as it is. And then the Abhisheka is performed, wherein each of the faces of Subramanya Swami is offered a special Naivedyam, a holy offering of some eatable, like a special rice which is prepared and offered, and a lot of Pushpa Malikas, like flower garlands and loose flowers, are offered to Subramanya Swami. And the way they do the Shatru Samhara Puja here is very, very, it's a wonderful experience, and it's a very totally out of the world kind of an experience which happens here. And once we do it, the effect is superb, because what exactly happens is either your enemies turn to become your friends and then they cooperate with you, they contribute to your growth, or they completely stop troubling you. One of the two things are happening as a result of this particular puja I have seen in so many people. Another wonderful feedback I have got with this particular puja from my clients is that they are able to progress very well in life in all aspects. Their health aspects are also really improved a lot. Anybody who is going through a Mangal Dasha particularly, or a Rahu Dasha, will really get benefited if they do this puja or Havan, because you know, they are controlled by Subramanya Swami, controls them and these planets, so it will really help you a lot. So even if you have a lot of debts and you know, you want to go approach a higher form of deity, not just the planets, then Subramanya Swami puja through Shatru Samhara Subramanya Swami to all the six faces of Subramanya is a very powerful way to approach your problem. And although we do this puja even in Bangalore or in our Yagnashala in Tamil Nadu, like in near Coimbatore, we also do take up pujas in such temples, because many times it so happens that when you do pujas in such holy places, the power gets magnified, and the result is so good that you know, it's instantaneous, I can say, because the power of this place is so good. Because I, like I said again, when India was affected by tsunami, particularly Tamil Nadu was affected, many parts of Tamil Nadu, this is the only place which remained untouched. And another good thing and surprising fact is that this holy place is below mean sea level, and despite of which this place remained untouched by the tsunami. And there are many other place things which are associated with this. We have this Ranganatha Swami Perumal here, and he's Swayambhu in this temple. If you personally visit the temple, you can also see the mountain or the parvata, Gandhamada Parvatam, with which the whole temple was constructed. Even that is there, so you can actually touch the a small portion of the holy hill, and you can prostrate and you know, also absorb the vibrations. And there is a Shatru Samhara Murti also here, where the Abhishekam and all happens during the day. Otherwise, the Moolavar or the main deity, that you can just go and have a darshan, or if there are prescribed timings where you actually go and get the darshan or Abhisheka done. So, otherwise, it has been a great experience to be here and take the blessings. And I thought, okay, at least when I'm shooting this video, you should get to see the Gopuram. And the best part of this is, normally Subramanya Swami holds his spear or veil in this way, but this is the only place where he is holding it like this. And here, I believe, like the priests have been saying, that when the Tarakasura was actually given a boon, nobody would be able to vanquish him other than Subramanya Swami. He had to get a special astra from Goddess Saraswati. So Devi Parvati arranged for a very special astra, that is a weapon which had the aksharas, the power of the aksharas from A to Ksha. So Devi Saraswati blessed him with that particular spear with which he actually vanquished Tarakasura or Surapadma. So this is a very, very different kind of a place. It's not like a normal, don't expect anything like any normal temple would be. It's a totally different vibration. It has beautiful view of the sea, and even the sea water has healing properties here. So it's really worth a visit. And even if you cannot visit personally, you want to get a puja done through us if you are abroad or anywhere else, like really far, but you want to get the blessings, you're most welcome. We can get it done for you here in the best way possible. So we can arrange for this puja, and we can see if we can send you the video shots also. And you can listen to the chants and feel the vibrations. It's really wonderful. So if you can't do anything else, you can at least connect to Subramanya Swami here, you know, by chanting Om Shiva Shiva Subramanyaya Namaha. Om Shiva Shiva Subramanyaya Namaha. Om Shiva Shiva Subramanyaya Namaha. This is the mantra which the priests keep chanting here. So when the puja is going on also, they tell us, don't sit idle, not doing anything. Chant Shiva Shiva Subramanyaya Namaha. So we chanted this all the time when we were there for the puja. And I'm so sure that when you book the puja next, we will do our best to get you a solution for your problem through Subramanya Swami's grace and blessings. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om Shiva Shiva Subramanyaya Namaha.